Good day, everyone. My name is Rudy Page from Making Connections Work, and welcome to another Global Entrepreneurship Week dialogue. Global Entrepreneurship Week aims to promote originality, creativity, and ingenuity through local and global business support networks. The week also serves as an opportunity to collaborate and engage with organizations and individuals to celebrate entrepreneurs, particularly those who are committed to serving local communities and neighborhoods across the world. So I'm so pleased that we've been able to invite Dr. Marina Nani from RW Magazine. Good day, Marina.
Happy first day. This is how I feel. It's a very beautiful morning here in London. The sun is up, and so our hearts are opening into infinite possibilities. Thank you for the opportunity, Rudy. It is my true privilege. And I can't tell you how grateful I am for having this conversation with you.
Thank you very much, Marina. Thank you very much indeed. Marina, let's start with that age-old question. Why did you become an entrepreneur?
Well, on reflection, Rudy, why not? Why should I limit myself? The truth is that I had no idea I am an entrepreneur. I've been a teacher for a long time. I love teaching. I've been always fascinated by what is happening on somebody else's face when they have a breakthrough and an aha moment, right? So I always love teaching, and I, at some point in my life, I've been facing great challenges simply because I was a young widow with three children, and one of the children was experiencing health issues. So as a teacher, you'll have a long period of time as a holiday. So I was taking extra jobs to be able to get the medication, the treatment my son needed at the time. So yes, doing these things opened my mind into different industries. And one of them was PR. And actually I was volunteering out of everything with three children, young widow, working a couple of jobs and volunteering. So by volunteering to that organization, they asked me and said, they said, look, you are so good with words. Can you spare more time? Mm-hmm. And I said, yeah, why not? Even I had perhaps 4 hours a day for sleep, but I always loved the beauty of words. I always loved poetry. And as a student, I remember I was having this monthly kind of gathering together where we were writing poetry, reading poetry. And then I done by hand, like a magazine, but it was by hand because you weren't allowed to have a typewriter at the time. And so we were gathering together once a month, reading each other's poetry and elevating each other. It was beautiful. So I always said yes to beautiful projects. And during that period of time, I had access to a couple of opportunities that really changed my life. And one of them was to apply to become the editor-in-chief of a publication. And it was part of a chain, so it was a franchise. So I never had the money to pay for the franchise, but what happened, the very people who I was volunteering for, they hired me. So I actually put together a large amount of money, which to me, it was like, I don't even know how to write this down, how many zeros. Yeah. And they bought advertising from me when I told them I wish I could do this because I would turn this this newspaper into an ecological newspaper. It was always my passion to look at nature and try to understand nature, how beautiful it is. So yes, this is how my my journey as an entrepreneur started, with the help of other people, because we are not defined by our decisions, as we might think we are, but actually it is whatever decision you make, if you don't have a group of people who believe in you, who value you, who support you, who are telling you, go for it, this is good, you are brilliant, you will never be able to achieve anything. Any of the decisions you are making in your own mind need to be translated into a need to help others. So yes, I had no idea I was an entrepreneur. Even now I wonder, am I? But it seems that I'm just drawn in by this bigger plan, the divine plan that we are all part of.
Absolutely, absolutely. Thanks for that. So what has been the three greatest lessons you have learned as an entrepreneur?
Oh, this is a great question. I learned more than three lessons, trust me. But I will start with the one that is very, very dear to my heart. And that is celebrate others.
Yeah.
Because I learned to celebrate myself from others. They told me, it's time to celebrate you. So for me, celebrating with no reason is a moral duty. You know, I wake up in the morning and I'm so happy. I don't have a clue if I have a reason or not, but I feel the need to celebrate life. And especially now, before COVID, I've been I had some health challenges. I didn't know I was ill. I've been ill for a long time and I had no idea, for years. And then in the middle of the night, I was taken to the hospital. And then for over 8 months, I've been a patient. Yeah. And while my patience was running out, I was released and fully recovered, and the amazing people at Chelsea Hospital told me I'm good to go. That day, the first lockdown started. Okay. And I had no idea what that means, but since then I've been celebrating the fact that I am alive, and celebrating that everybody around me is alive. And we lost friends, dear friends, tragic moments. And that is a great reason for introspection, understanding that celebrating each other is more important than anything. Celebrating not because it's your birthday or because you have a big win, celebrating because you are here together and this is your chance. Every day it's a blank canvas and you really have the chance to get together with somebody you don't know, a total stranger, because I promise you that is going to get you closer to who you are yourself. So celebrating others, of course, celebrating life together and celebrating everything in between, but celebrating the people you know or you don't know yet. I think for me, it's an adventure, and I'm so grateful of knowing you. I mean, look at you, make connection work. God, I mean, I know thousands of people, literally thousands of people who are doing this networking and connections, and they are the queen or the king of connections in a certain industry, but you make connections work. And it is true. It is exactly that. This is who you are. And that enabled me to celebrate you, to celebrate the people who you are working with and the people I'm working with because of you. So thank you so much, Rudy. So celebration and celebrating others' lives and their human potential, I think, is number one for me. The second one, perhaps not many people are going to like it, but you know, I got to be less wise as I become younger every day. So I'm going to say it anyway. So I think this is something that, you know, took me a long time to understand. Mm. it is not of my business what other people think of me.
Right.
My only business is what I think of myself.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
There are energies. Everything is energy. And it's so easy to get down. You know, you go to a meeting and there'll be people thinking you are better than them and they need to eliminate you or whatever it is, right?
Yeah.
So there are people who don't really understand that actually competition doesn't exist. It's an artificial concept invented to pull down the 97%. So it's the bigger picture that I'm going to in now, but I'm going to come out very quickly. So because I can talk for days about the 97% and the social conditioning and the limiting beliefs. So in reality, is none of my business what other people think of me, because I am here to complete you.
Yeah.
I'm here because you complete me.
Yeah.
So the world is this gigantic poem, 8 billion verses. And guess what? Every verse is an universe. So my universe is very important that this is happening in my lifetime, is completing somebody else's universe. Because other people's universe is completing my universe. And this is why I'm here right now. And I'm still live and kicking and never been so excited about life as I am today. So that's number two. And number three, the lesson that I learned is that there is so much human potential around us, within us. And this is coming down to what society is missing. Mm. Because when you don't elevate the talent in front of you, you don't understand is not only their loss, is humans, the whole society, the humanity's loss. Mm-hmm. When society is not celebrating and supporting a talent, regardless they are now based in Ivory Coast or South America or North America, regardless where they are located right now, there is a need for humanity to celebrate that talent, to nurture that talent, to support that person, simply because, yes, they will suffer if they are not supported and they don't develop themselves. But the reality is that the whole humanity is suffering. Absolutely. We are not here by ourselves. We are really part of the same big picture, which is a huge, gigantic puzzle. And one piece missing ruins the whole picture. It's incomplete. The picture is not complete unless we support the human potential that is silent in somebody, that unique gift that they've been given at birth, because that gift is unique to them. Mm. And it's unique to them simply because the world needs that unique gift. Mm. So yes, there might be only 300 industry or 500, I can't remember now, but there are 8 billion extraordinary people, and each one of them is bringing something amazing at the table should they be being supported and should they be given the chance to become who they are destined to be. So it's not a matter of becoming better, or it's, I think, on a from a self-perception point of view, it's a matter of remembering who I am destined to be, remembering that my story, yes, is mine. And I have the choice to put my name on it or not, to share it, but belongs to the world. My story belongs to the world because it's not about me. It's about the people I could help along the way.
Absolutely. And that brings us nicely to our final question. Can entrepreneurs be servant leaders whilst pursuing their business ambitions?
Well, there are a couple of words there that are very, very powerful. So, you see, 10 years ago, I've been speaking in front of a large audience, and total accident. So I wasn't even designed to be there. Somebody dragged me on front of these people who paid a lot of money to be there, and just happened that they needed me to say something, but nobody told me what they want me to say. and just happened that I had no idea I have a story. Mm-hmm. And they wanted me to share my story. And you know what? I wasn't the only one. Thousands of people in that room had no idea they had a story. Mm-hmm. It was me discovering on stage in front of them that I have a story. Mm-hmm. And that changed everything for me. Because since my passion is to broadcast mm-hmm. your passion, mm-hmm. and I can't help it. It's not like I have this ambition or that ambition. It's nothing like that. It's simply, I can't help it. I'm constantly thinking who I am not celebrating today, right. Who I left behind, because I don't want to leave anyone behind. Mm-hmm. And this is why I created Rich Human Society, which is the first community of conscious influencers. It's a private community and is created simply because of the 97.3% divide in society. Mm. And conscious influencers are people, are the entrepreneurs you are mentioning, right? They don't have ambitions. They have dreams.
Yes.
And as an editor in chief of Rich Human Magazine, I should say this quarter we have, or for the next two quarters, we have a goal, a financial goal. Mm-hmm. I don't really care. It's not about that. We have a dream by the end of April 2022 to share the first 1 million untold stories. Right. You see? So this is what it is. And I had to create a team. We have over 200 editors now from 5 continents, and they're very well-educated, amazing people who have a solution for a certain challenge. Yes. And they serve, like me, they serve the ant, mm-hmm. right? So if you think of the word servant, because 10 years ago when I was on that stage, I discovered that word in front of everyone. And I said, I am a servant. I'm here to serve the ant. Everybody start laughing because that time the word servant wasn't that well used. And anyway, so when I said that, people stood up and, you know, showed me that I was on something. I was onto something. So a servant leader is a leader who understands self-leadership, who awakened the leader within. Each one of us is born to be a leader. Each one of us is born to do greater things, better things than ever before. And now it's 2021. You are just a click away from delivering value. You are just ready. You are born ready. You need just to remember who you are destined to be. And I don't know if this answers your question, but I feel that every single entrepreneur is driven not by financial gain, because they would have joined a corporation, right? And there would have been stupid money, paid stupid money for doing nothing.
That's right.
But entrepreneurs are the destiny helpers, yes. are the people who are here to serve, the people who got dreams, the people who believe in a fairer society. So yes, I think every single entrepreneur is here for helping others.
Thank you very much. And you answered that perfectly. And I'm so pleased that with this dialogue, Global Entrepreneurship Week with Making Connections Work and Fresh FM Radio London. That was Dr. Marina Nanny from Rich Woman Magazine. Thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Marina.
Thank you for this unique opportunity. Thank you for making connections works, really. Thank you.
Cheerio.